Hey, what's up, everybody? It's been a long time since I've done a video on here. I've actually deleted all my videos and just kind of starting over. One of the things I do is collect a lot of different stuff. I collect Oakley sunglasses, Invicta watches, a bunch of other watches. Here recently, probably in the last 3 to 4 years, I've been collecting Ridge wallets and Ridge products. Actually started buying them back in 2013 when they very first came out. I had the 10th anniversary wallet. Got about 50 or 60 wallets. As one of their select customers, they send me stuff from time to time to review. And what they sent me today is something I'm extremely excited about. They sent me some of their new luggage, their travel collection. My understanding is they have a new suitcase. It's going to be for travel on a plane. Hopefully it's going to fit in a bin and going to be able to be a carry-on. There's supposed to be a backpack and some other things. So I'm just going to get started. Just wanted to do an unboxing here and maybe look at it, check the quality out, and show everybody what they offer on their travel package. It looks like high quality stuff on the website. Most of their stuff is high quality. If you have any Ridges, if you have some unique Ridge stuff or any higher end Ridge stuff, like some of the original real Damascus steel, not the laser etched, hit me up. I'd be interested in buying that off of you. Any of the artist series, like the 1000 Bunnies. He did a couple, the Marco Serratelli. But today we're going to look at the luggage and the travel collection. There's a lot of packing in here. First thing here on top looks like it's the backpack. Still wrapped up, so we'll pull that one out here in a minute. It's a big box for everything it has in here. This looks like it's going to be the packing cubes. And we should have, hopefully, another item in here. It's going to be the Ridge dock kit for the toiletry bag right here. And then down here at the bottom is what we're really after, which is going to be the suitcase. I recently saw Travis Barker was doing some work for the Ridge, and he had got some of their stuff. So I decided to go with the blue. Can't remember exactly what color they call it. It's like, I don't know if it's cobalt blue or alpine navy is actually what they call it. So that should be everything in here. Make sure. Just a packing slip and then we'll get to it. So the first thing I want to do is kind of take a look at these packing cubes. Pull them out and kind of see what they are. They're probably the least important item in here, but I don't usually use packing cubes when I travel. I probably travel 10, 12 times a year, at least once a month for work or for pleasure. One of the things it looks like the packing cubes is has three smaller ones. Looks like they're all the same size. And we've actually got some kind of plastic on them, I guess, to keep that looking nice. And then you can open them up. These small ones probably would be good for socks. Grab a few and see. Throw a couple pairs of socks in there. Zip it up. And you kind of go from there. Keeps things organized in your suitcase. Like I said, these are all three the same size. And then you have this bigger one. And it's probably going to be good for something more like, you know, throwing a couple shirts in here. You might be able to fit jeans in there if they're packed tight or rolled. This is a pretty good size one here. I would probably say it would be better maybe if they had included two and two instead of one of these and three small ones. But I'm sure, you know, from a financial perspective, they have to make sure that they're making money. That's a pretty good size there, but it'd be nice if you had like two, maybe one for shirts, one for jeans or pants, a couple shorts. And then, you know, if you have two of those, then maybe two of these, one for underwear and then one for socks or something like that. What I like to do is use them, and then I have like a laundry bag, but supposedly there's supposed to be a laundry bag inside the suitcase. So we'll see when we get there. So that's the pack of cubes. We'll move on next to the dot kit or the toiletry bag. I have the original Ridge dot kit, which is the same thing as a toiletry bag. From what I can remember, it's green, and it's probably a little bit bigger than this one. I'd run in there and get it, but don't know exactly where it is. This looks very nice. Looks like it has some good quality to it. You can hang it. It has a hanger on there. I like to do that when I'm in a hotel. I'll throw that up on if they have one of those little mirrors and just let it hang there. Good size, it looks like. And then on the back side, or maybe this is actually the front side, this is the back side. So on the back side, you have this pocket here, and then you have a large opening. You could probably put shaving cream, maybe, you know, a bottle of cologne, toothpaste, things like that. And then, oh, it looks like it actually has a handle also, which is nice. And then here on the front, looks like this is the main pouch. And it has lots of stuff. You could probably fit a toothbrush in here. In here, probably put some Q-tips or cotton swabs. That's what I usually use for this one. This layout's very similar to the old Ridge toiletry bag, if you have it. It has, I believe, these same three things. So it has a small one here. I usually put, like I said, put some cotton swabs in there. On this one here, you could probably put, you know, like a small bottle of shampoo or something like that. Maybe one of those small little travel sizes of a mouthwash or something. And then you got a little bigger side over here. Kind of weird. It doesn't unzip all the way. Maybe you could put, like I said, maybe a bottle of cologne or something there. A toothbrush here. Has a lot of good pockets in here. Probably could open this up here and then put a couple other smaller things. What I usually have just for me, I kind of go down. I don't really have hair, but I'll occasionally put some lotion for my head. Put cotton swabs in here. I'll put, you know, a toothbrush, toothpaste, of course, some mouthwash, some shaving cream. You gotta have your razor, so that's another one. You maybe put your razor in here, put it up here. So very nice on the toiletry bag. It's got a lot of extra space. You could probably fit everything you need in this front back, pocket here. But like I said, you've also got this back pocket, which is kind of open, just to drop some other items in there. And then you have even another one on the back side of it, an exterior pocket. So very nice. I kind of really like that. It's pretty awesome. And then it has a nice emblem here. I'll kind of put that up so you can see it. Carbon fiber Ridge emblem. So very nice on the toiletry bag. Next thing we're going to get to is the backpack. That's another thing that I have a tendency to collect is bags and backpacks. The thing I collect with bags is either Oakley usually. I also have a ton of alpaca bags, sling bags and things like that. You can tell immediately this is very, very good quality. Same little emblem you have here on the front, carbon fiber Ridge on the front. It looks like you have a nice pocket on the front there. Kind of trying to look at it here and look at all the pockets. I kind of tend to like some of the exterior pockets, and I'll tell you that's one of the things with Ridge backpacks that I have never really been a big fan of. One of the things that I asked them, because I do talk to their design team from time to time just because I buy so much from them. And one of the things that I had asked was that they do a backpack that has quite a bit more exterior pockets. I don't really like to get into the main part of a backpack all the time. This one definitely fits that mold. It's got side pockets on the sides here. Man, this is very good quality too, you can tell. Looks like it has some kind of like nylon here, so the pocket doesn't open completely. That's probably more for like you could probably slide a water bottle in there. Hopefully this one is a little bit different, but we'll see. It might be the same thing. Yeah, it looks like it's the same thing. Well, not completely the same. It has a place to hold the pocket from opening all the way, but then it also has a little elastic divider in there. So it is a little bit different. You could probably put a bottle of cologne, you know, maybe a couple of pins down in here. I like to keep, you know, I don't put all of my cards in my wallet because I carry a Ridge wallet. So I have another wallet that I keep with some extra cards in there. You can throw that one down in there. Pretty good size. This pocket here, it goes all the way down deep into the bag. It goes all the way to the bottom. Doesn't look like there's any dividers or anything in here, but you could throw a pair of sunglasses in there. Again, maybe a pen or a notebook, some field notes, things of that nature. Looks like they have some leather tabs here on the front just for aesthetics. But it's a very nice bag so far from what I'm seeing. Yeah, it looks like that's the only difference on the side pockets is this one on the, if you're looking at it from the front, the one on the right side here has an extra divider in there. So, looks pretty nice. Looks like you have multiple compartments here. I'm going to open this front one here. It looks like it opens kind of like a clamshell on this backpack. Opens all the way up. And then you have two very large pockets here in the front. You could put, again, you know, I like to carry like a book for Sudoku or something like that. And put that in there. It looks like back here on the back, there's multiple different pockets on the back side of this. Looks like, not sure what this is here because you can't really hang anything on it. Maybe for Velcro, I don't know. It looks like you could put some things down in here. There's a large zipper pocket back here. Assuming maybe you could throw like a tracker in there. You could put some other things. Again, maybe a wallet. Probably would, if you're gonna use your cell phone, probably wanna put it in one of these front pockets, namely this one. But it looks like it's pretty nice there. It looks like there's actually three openings on this bag. So you have your front clamshell opening, and then it looks like there's a middle opening here. But actually that's the same compartment. I was wondering what that was because it looked like it couldn't fit another pocket in there. But if you want to open it up clamshell, you can. Or if you just want to get into the top of it, you can also do that. So you're getting into the same compartment whether you open the front compartment or you open this one. And it looks like they do have right here a tracking a pocket here for a tracker, like a Apple AirTag or something like that for your tracking device. And this zips up. So quite a bit of room in the back there. You kind of saw when I had this open, you know, you have a pretty good size there. Normally this is going to be zipped up if you have the front clamshell open. And then you have a nice handle there. And then it looks like the third opening is going to be for a laptop. It's a separate compartment. Very nice lined in there. You know, it's kind of hard to see, but it has like a weave pattern. Very good quality stuff. On the back here, it looks like you have your sternum strap here. Trying to kind of see how that actually opens. So it's vidlock, opens up like that. You have a handle here, or you can use that to, I guess, slide through on the luggage. And then you've also got, looks like, another pocket here on the back. You know, I see these sometimes. I don't know what people typically use them for. You know, I guess you could throw something in there, maybe a passport or something like that. It's not a nice little touch that they have there on the back to have another pocket. I thought, looking at the photos, that this was going to be the pass-through, but it's not. This is the pass-through right here, and then you actually have another pocket. This is pretty hard here on the back, so, you know, should protect your items well. A lot of good mesh here for walking through an airport or something like that. It's nice that you can slide these up and down or completely off. I would say be careful because they probably could come off while you're traveling. So probably don't need to have the sternum strap on. I don't usually wear a sternum strap, but you know, that's up to you. So that's the backpack. Looks like they have something else here. Let's see what this is. Not sure what it is. It is something. I'm going to be honest with you, I have no idea what that is. Maybe some type of divider. Probably something I'm going to need to ask about. That must be what this is for. So, yeah, that's what this is for. You can actually put a shelf inside this backpack so you can separate things. That's what, if you remember earlier, I was saying, I don't know what this is. It looks like something for Velcro. That's going to be what this is for. So you can put that in there. You can actually use this as a shelf. I don't know what you'd use it for, but maybe if you wanted to put some shoes down here and have some clothes up here and not have to contaminate them. You have two levels. You can also bring this down and put it down here. So that's probably more for, like, again, if you wanted to have shoes, you probably could easily fit some shoes down in here. If you carry clothes, I don't typically carry clothes in a backpack. I carry like some headphones I usually put down in here. I probably wouldn't use this shelf very much, so I probably wouldn't even put it in a bag. But it's an option. It's always good to have. This is very sturdy. It's hard. It's very nice. It has the Ridge logo on it. So, hey, something different. So that is the backpack. And then, as you can see, it's matching. Again, this is the Alpine Navy. Looks really nice together. And then we can get to the actual nice items. When I say nice, I mean what we're really looking for. This is all pretty nice stuff. So looking here on the suitcase, very nice wheels. You can tell high quality, probably not easily going to break. They're very sturdy. On the back side here, it looks like you have your handle all the way down. I'm not sure what this is, if it just stands up or if there's a way to move that. I'll have to check on that a little bit. Some of the design stuff that they do is unique, so that may do something else, I don't know. Nice handle here on the top. It looks like it has bumper guards all the way around on the top. Same logo there for, I don't know what that is. Same logos you have here on these other two more expensive items. And then it looks like you actually have a combination lock here to open it up. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up and we'll take a look inside. Get this stuff out of the way. So when you open it up, you notice immediately, a lot of mesh. Looks like this side is more for clothes you want to strap up. And this is going to be your laundry bag. Looks like they have it actually attached to the straps. I don't know if you want to do that, but that's cool. You could keep that in the bottom. And then as you are out and about, or as your trip goes on, you could keep it there. And then you could just throw your clothes in the laundry bag, or you can actually separate it from these. They separate pretty easily. Looks like maybe they just had that on there to keep it there, because they come off pretty easily. The laundry bag is actually fairly sturdy. It doesn't look like it really folds up, so you can throw your laundry down in there and then you can lay it down on either side. Pretty nice touch. Has nice Ridge lining here. It looks like you can zipper unzip this if you wanted to. So, like I said, very nice lining. Put this back over here. Again, you can strap your clothes in. If you want to, you can strap that there. It'd be nice. Maybe they do. It looks like there's some paperwork there. If they maybe had some paperwork in here to show you how everything goes, that would be nice. But it looks like there's paperwork in there. You stand this up, same thing. You have a pocket here for an AirTag, Apple AirTag, or some other tracking device. You can utilize that one. There's an open pocket here, and it includes in here, let's see, it includes like a eraser, like a magic eraser, probably to clean the outside. That's a nice touch. Looks like we got something else too. Well, maybe this is the laundry bag. So I'd have to say I'm not sure what this actually is, because this is the laundry bag. So nice. You don't have to get your dirty clothes mixed with your clean clothes. So definitely a lot of extras, I would say. Says find more information here. So probably we'll scan that and see what I can find. And then it tells you here how to set the lock here. This is probably going to be the luggage tag. Very nice leather luggage tag. Says Ridge on the outside. You know, that's a nice touch. Just some of the fine detail that Ridge does, I think, is very nice. Something like this. You know, this is real leather. Nice luggage tag. I think they sell this for like $25 online. If you buy this, you don't need it because it comes with it. Again, a nice Ridge insignia here, weatherproof series. And there's even something else in here. It looks like maybe a shoe bag. So lots of extras with this suitcase. I'll have to find out exactly what this is for. This opens up, and then you have a whole other opening for more clothes in the bottom of the suitcase. So for the whole get up, I guess, the entire collection, you have the suitcase. It includes whatever this bag is. I'm not sure. Maybe. I don't know. It has this this laundry bag, and that's what it says, mesh laundry bag here. You get a shoe bag. You get the luggage tag that you had, and then you also get a magic eraser. So that's really nice to go with the whole collection. Pretty much everything you need to go on maybe a weekend trip or maybe a four-day trip. Probably wouldn't want to go much longer than that and use this suitcase. It is fairly small. When I say small, it would definitely fit in the overhead compartment of a airplane. It definitely fits the carry-on size. But you probably wouldn't be able to go away for a week in this. You probably would need something a little bit bigger. So it's more for probably a short 3 to 5 day trip at the most. But this is the collection here. And I'd say overall, haven't used it yet, so I'll give you some impressions once I use it. But overall, just looking at the quality of the items, I'd probably say about an 8.5 out of 10. So let me know what you think. If you have any questions, just put them in the comments. Thank you.